Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome back to online classes of Semstar Global School. I am Fizza Akhtar, and I am here to discuss another topic with you all, and that is subject and predicate. We have already discussed in our previous lecture that a group of words that makes a complete sense is called a sentence. Why I am repeating this? Because every sentence has two main parts. One is a subject, the other is a predicate. And when we make a sentence, we name some person or thing and say something about that person or thing. In other words, or in simple terms, the part which names the person or thing that we are speaking about becomes the subject of the sentence. That means the subject tells us who or what the sentence is about. And the part of the sentence that tells us something about the subject is called the predicate of the sentence. Or I can say the part that gives you any other information about the subject is called the predicate. So let us understand the definition of subject and predicate with the help of few examples. The first one, the new student walked into the class. So if I ask you, what are we talking about in this sentence, or about whom are we talking about? So you will get the answer, the new student. That means this is my subject. The next one, Rohit wrote a letter. Again the same thing, who wrote a letter? We are getting the answer, Rohit. The next one. The victim was taken to the hospital. You can ask the same question again. Who was taken to the hospital? Or about whom are we talking in the sentence? We are talking about the victim. That is our subject. One more. Both the players and the officers were honored for their performance. In this sentence, we can see two subjects. That means we are talking about two persons here, the players and the officers. So, seeing the given examples, I can conclude this, or I can tell you that the subject can also be categorized into three kinds. Yes, there are three kinds of subjects. The first one, a subject can be made from a single word comprising of a noun or a pronoun. This we have seen in example number 2. Rohit wrote a letter. We had one single word, Rohit, that was acting as our subject. The next kind is, a subject can be a phrase containing a noun or any article or modifier. This we have seen in example number 3. The victim was taken to the hospital. We had one article, the, and we had one word or noun, victim. And these two were acting as a phrase. The third one is, a subject can be two or more nouns, pronouns or noun phrases that may be joined by any conjunction. This we have seen in the last example. Both the players and the officers were honored for their performance. That means we had two words or two nouns, the players and the officers, that was acting as our subject, and it was joined by a conjunction and. So any such sentence which has two or more subjects is known as a compound subject. In this part of the video, we had discussed the definitions of subject and predicate along with their examples and the kinds of subject. In the next part, we'll learn more on this topic. Till then, stay safe. Thank you.